In 67, my friend had a clothing store, my best friend since I'm 11 years old. He started a clothing store, like a boutique, right in a hip neighborhood of Chicago in, you know, late 60s when a lot was happening. And I was of that age, and it was a really exciting time. Carved up some heads, bought some chisels, and was working my friend's clothing store, and I had them up on the shelves. And a guy came in and bought three big heads. For me, it was like a ton of money. And decided to go to Europe with two friends. And we drove from Holland to Afghanistan, Kabul. One fella came back, and me and the other guy went all the way, and we split up, and I spent 4.5 months in India. All the time thinking, when I get back, I'm gonna buy tools, hand tools, and I'm gonna be a wood sculptor. I had 6 months to think about myself, so it was my college. I learned about me. Then in 1979, I moved out to the desert. My friend bought a little shack, kind of near Joshua Tree National Monument. And just to be secluded and see what it was like away from the city. And I really got into my work. And then married my wife 3 years later, who had two young children. And where I was living, everything was rounded hills. She was rounded. The kids were soft and rounded. And my work began to change more of these figures of roundness, which I call figure scapes today.
There's a lot of factors. You get a block of wood. I didn't want to like carve all that wood away. I wanted to utilize as much as I could of the block. It's 41 years that I'm carving that, so I mean, masks, puppets, animals. You know, you venture off and just think things that are fun to make, basically.
Mm-hmm.